So this is the part 2 of our VLAN configuration. So let's get started. First of all, we need to create VLANs. So VLANs actually. Okay, sales. Exit. 20 accounts. VLAN 30. Engineering, exit, 99, management, exit. Now that we have configured our VLANs, now we have to make S1 as a VTP server. So we have to type VTP mode server, VTP domain, can be anything. But make sure you put domain whatever you are putting on all the switches. VTP password Cisco, and the password should be also the same for every switch in the VLAN configuration. Now we have to configure this switch with a management IP address where it can be monitored or it can be managed from the remote PCs from anywhere in the network. So IP address would be 192.99.10 and its subnet mask. Okay, that's it. We also have to specify a default gateway which would be in the same subnet as the management VLAN. Okay, now we have done that. Now we need to configure ports. Ports from FA06 to 10. 10, sorry. Not this. This is for the other switch. We need to configure trunking ports. Sorry, trunking ports. These are the trunking ports because from port number one. Sorry, this is one, I guess. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Altogether 5. So we'll configure trunking ports on all these switches as well as on these. So from here, not this, ignore this part, only this. So switch port mode trunk, switch port trunk native VLAN, and that would be 99. No shut, make sure you give a no shut. Exit, close this thing, go over here. So before we configure S2, let me tell you, on S1 we configured we made the S1 switch as a server and we configured VLANs on it. So you don't have to configure VLANs on this and this one, because as you know, when you create a service on a servers, it deploys the services and the clients accept those. So we'll make S2 and S3 as a client. So we don't have to create VLANs over here. Let's start making this switch as a client. VTP mode client instead of server. VTP domain. Make sure you put the same domain. In this case, Lester. Cisco. And the password should be same. Now we'll put the management IP address, which is 99 dot, there it was 10. Now we'll put here as 20. That's it. Now we'll put default gateway, which would be the same as the management VLAN, and the default gateway will be the same for every switch. So right now we have to configure the trunking ports from 1 to 5. Interface, range, 1 to 5. trunk, switch port, trunk, native VLAN, sorry, VLAN, VLAN, no shut, exit. That's about it. Now we need to configure S3. Okay, enter. Okay, the password is Cisco, all the switches and routers. Enable class CLASS. Okay, config. Then we need to configure this as client. The domain is master. The password is Cisco. Okay, now we need to configure the management IP address 99.30. No shut, exit. Need to configure default gateway. Make sure you keep it the same default gateway for everything. Need to insert the range for trunking. Trunk, support, trunk, native, VLAN, 99, no shirt, exit. So now after creating all configuring the trunking ports, now we need to configure the access links. So we go over here, same as interface range. So I mentioned port 6 to 10 will have 10 VLAN 10, 11 to 15 20, and 16 to 20 will be VLAN 30. So 6 to 10 is switch port mode. Instead of switch port mode trunk, it's switch port mode access, and switch port access, sorry, VLAN, and the VLAN for that is 10. Okay, need to type no shut at the end. Okay, now this is from 11 to 15, which is for VLAN 20. Switch port mode access, switch port access, VLAN 20. No shut, exit. So now this is the configuration for VLAN 30. Mode access, no shut, exit. So that's about it. So let's try and ping the systems. I'm trying to ping from here to here. It's successful. So what if I try to ping from here to here? So it says request timeout. So it's not working. Why? Because we have not configured this router for its sub interface. So we'll go over here. Okay, enable Cisco. Okay, it's class actually. Config the interface fast ethernet 0/0, type no shutdown. Okay, and now we have to create sub interfaces. You can give any number you want, but let's stick to 10 for the VLAN 10. So we need to type encapsulation.1q and the VLAN which it resembles. So for this it is VLAN 10. Now you have to type the IP address, which is the default gateway, .10.1, and no shut, exit. Now we need to create the same way the other ones, 20, encapsulation.1q, 20. Okay, 20, 32 pound for no shirt. Except we need to create 99 and make sure we put native after that, only for the management villain. For gateway for that is 99.1, no shirt, except. So let's go over here and try to ping the PC. Now it should be successful. You can see this is successful. How about trying to ping 20? This is successful as well. So as you can see, this is working right now. So I hope I made it clear. And still, if you have some problem configuring the switches and stuff like, please leave a comment below. I'll get back to it, and I'll make sure to put this lab in the. I'll put a link in the description where you can download this lab, so that you can practice. Again, if you have a problem configuring, please leave a comment below. Thanks for watching.